Hello and welcome back. I'm SK Drake, and as you can tell, a lot has changed in my little temporary house. Everything is gone. So, alright. Let's see, there's gonna be a link in the description about this. This is similar to Generic B's setup. That's when I first saw it, but hold on a second, let me pull this guy's name up. Drax IP has a tutorial on how this works, how the cards work. It's really great tutorial. I watched that and I was good to go. But only two rows are set up with chips right now because they need a lot the freaking flowers. Oh, I'm about to kill that enderman. Anyways, yeah, here's my request pipe. You know, just look at it, say, I want all of those. Submit. And it comes shooting out. And I don't want sticks anymore. Put it on there. I got the crafting table right here. So when I make something, extra stuff, I can just toss it right in there. And it's gone. The farm, my little tiny wheat farm, is huge. This is where it started out last episode, and now it takes up all this. The great thing with these planters, you don't need water at all. So I upgraded both of these. The harvester, it's got the diamond upgrade, which lets it cut down this whole thing. Get on my nerves. And out of here. Okay, we get stuck on the wall. And the planter, and it's upgraded with diamonds. It took forever. I was on most today. As you can tell, I got new weapons. Yeah, I kind of got killed, and then after I died, blown up by a creeper. Not sure how that works, but it was cheap. Not once, but twice. I lost everything. I lost everything, remade it all, lost it all again, including my knapsack, which has stuff in there. All that stuff, yeah, I lost all that stuff, made it again, lost it again. But whatever. But yeah, here's how it works. So, the planter plants the seeds. Come over here. Harvester is gonna chop them all down. It's got a pneumatic, whatever it is. It's got one of these in there, and just disable the red signal and hit it with the wrench to make it output. It's gonna spit everything out, these little item ducts. I don't even need to upgrade them. This system isn't like super fast. And in here, I got a whitelisted one for seeds. So seeds are gonna go in there and fill that up. Then the wheat, we can't go in there, so it's gonna keep coming and coming all the way back here. Oh, and I got the sludge boiler. I didn't show you that. Let me show you this real quick. Alright, as this harvester works, it's gonna start filling up with sludge. Now, we're gonna jump down there in a second. So, I got the sludge coming out these fluid ducts. Cause once the harvester is full of sludge, it'll stop working. And it goes into this sludge boiler. And the sludge boiler turns sludge into either sand, gravel, stone, and just something. And that gets fed into my storage system. Bloop. And oh look, there goes some wheat now. Bloop. Drops in the chest. I got two deep storage. Here, we got a dynamic item response chip in this one. And it's set for priority one on wheat. So all the wheat goes in there. And that one is dirt. So it's got the same thing, dynamic whatever chip, as opposed to the item responder chip. don't know if there's a difference, but that's how it is. Okay, so everything's gonna go down to the bottom, then it's gonna come up here. It's gonna go across, go all the way down, go across, go up, go across, then all the way down. Yeah. But I'm gonna cover this up, make it look all pretty. And that's gonna be the wall of my house right around there somewhere. I don't wanna be too far from the storage area, because then it's just gonna take forever to get items. And another thing I need is to speed up the system, you need emeralds. So we gotta make a auto spawner. Wait. And I also put up a fence. I tried running that system all the way over to the feeder to autofill the feeder with wheat, and I don't know if I was doing something wrong, but it wasn't working. So right now it's just manual. But I've put the fencing all around the entire thing. It's a too high, some places it's 3, but it goes all the way around, and even some of these, there's like caves under there somewhere. I know there are. Well, not like that. That's a little thing. Up here somewhere. Over by this waterfall area. No, that's not a cave. Well, it's a cave. Not a real cave. Let me show you. See? Yeah. Like, I've blocked off those caves down there, too. I think it looks awesome. But this way, our little Triceratops should not be able to escape. Hopefully. I don't know. We'll find out. We're gonna set him loose. So let's run on back here. And I'm not sure. I'm pretty sure I ain't gotta block that off, but I don't know if I'm gonna put a gate there to walk in. But that's only gonna be a few dinosaurs, it's not gonna be too dangerous. Let's see. Here's our Triceratops. The book. Oh, there. That's what I need to. I really wanna get more dinosaurs. Hopefully he doesn't run across this. I want the... Gotta get the meteors from the moon first. But yeah, here's the little feeder we made. And just threw a whole bunch of wheat in there. It eats the wheat and turns it into green numbers. But here we go. Aww, he's so cute. He's 0 days old. Why is he so beat up? Why are you beat up? He ain't a chicken. Wait, let's get out of here. There he is. Little baby Triceratops in his own little pen. But I went all the way around. It's on the outer side of the river, except for on the back. I enclosed it on this side of the river. Stay in there now. Stay in there being a good Triceratops. And they're supposed to not like water, so hopefully he doesn't do anything crazy. You stay in here and be good. But yeah, so I need emeralds for upgrading these freaking chips. And there was something I was gonna make that I needed emerald. What was it? I don't remember. Anyways, there's something I need emeralds for. So I need an auto spawner. Auto spawner takes mob essence to run. So to get mob essence, we gotta do this. Alright, well, not this stuff's just in there. So we can do these grinders. What we're gonna do is I'm gonna move a skelly and a zombie spawner over here. Down here. Wait, is it here or is it here? Hold on a second. Wait a second. What's this? I thought it was this one. It is that one. Okay. Why is that there? Oh. I'm an idiot. Don't mind me. I had this all worked out beforehand. And then I forgot everything. I was like, what am I doing? I don't know. Let's see. First, no. Why would I do that? We need our aqueous accumulator. Put you down. You. And that's just gonna, get water. And we need. Coming up there. I think I have too many holes. I don't. I don't know what I'm doing. Alright, well, anyways. Water right here. But the same thing, it's just gonna have its own power source. Just so I don't have to worry about it. Alright, we'll put you there. Same thing as last time, just fill up and it's just gonna. That's our signal disabled. And it's full water. Alright. Next is steam turbine. Now, if you saw generic bees episode. I think it was his last one, I'm not sure, but he just makes this steam turbine. It's real easy to make. You take a steam dynamo and add some more parts to it. Real simple. But that creates energy from water. That's it. Just give it water and it'll make energy. So, I need this. Oh, I need my energy. It's gonna come right here and right here. Okay. That's what happened. I forgot the glass. That's right. We're not. Turn this thing on. Next is the grinders. Grinder. And these are easy. The machine frame, section, invar sword. Which you make that in. Let's see, where is it? Does it show the one I did? Molten invar. Ah, yes. There you go. It's a 2 iron to 1 ferrous. We'll make an ingvar. I think these go this way. No. want the grinder teeth facing towards the slaughterhouse. And put you there. Let's do this. Oh, I needed two tubes to come up. You got the items. I think that's what it is. So out of this, oh, I needed two of these servos. Dang it. And I need to grab my wrench to make these outputs. But oh, you were supposed to go with that one. Okay. I see. And the liquid comes up that one. Alright. Where's my wrench? Oh, don't think I made a new one. Nope. So I need some tin. And iron. Yeah. To do that, you have to select all, submit. Select all, submit. Otherwise, it doesn't work. Now, I think it's this. No, it's the other way. There we go. And see, I'm done with those. Throw those in there, throw that in there. I step and see it's already getting sucked off. Bye bye. Alright, so oh, and a servo. I need to make one of those. That is two of those, submit. Two of those, submit. Iron. Maybe two of those. Let's see, two iron, one redstone, one glass. Alright, I got it. Shift click, and bam. Don't need you. Alright, let's, so this needs to be filled up with dirt right here. This is going up that way. Alright, so I can do that one too. Go loop. Then installed. Then installed. And ignore redstone signal. Grab the wrench. Right click empty. Ignore redstone signal. And output. And alright, now we go. Alright, it is there. Yeah, because I wanted to connect it right there. So it goes bloop, right into our chest. So anything it spits out is going to come into this chest, and this chest is going to suck it all out. Really? Oh no, not those. And they get sucked up. It's not a high speed system because I don't think he's going to be generating a ton. And next up is I did block that for no reason because I still need the fluid. Don't mind me. I don't know what I'm doing. Now, I'm pretty sure you can just suck it off the top. I don't think these got a. Oh, they do. Output. So, do I need pneumatic turbos for these? I think I do. No pneumatic servo installed. Ah, jeez. Let's get that. Redstone, two redstone, smith. Iron. All smith. Glass. All smith. And we got blueprint. We need two of those. Got the extra in there. And go back down. I'm gonna pity this up. It's not gonna be this junk just hanging out and making a mess of the place. Throw you in there. Throw you in there. And I'll take out disables. That's not taking out disables. But yeah, see, look at these things. These are fully charged and they should never run out of energy because of that. Right now, all I'm going to do is use one of these. And it just holds six. Oh, dang it. That is the little sludge thing. It gives you hunger whenever it's working, which makes this area not safe sometimes. Put that in there. Put these back in there. Ooh, one thing I did find when I was out and about was a broken ancient sword. Oh yeah, we're gonna be making that soon. And see how I got some of this like dino stuff in here? I'm gonna have that stuff. It's gonna be in the system, but it's gonna be stored over there. Instead of in here. But I can still access it from the house, because it's going to be my house area over here. Gonna move the freaking Tinker's Construct smeltery, though, because I need to melt down villagers so I can get emeralds. Yeah, who wants to do the whole train thing? We need to melt villagers. I need auto spawner, so... Oh! We need to go back downstairs to the area I just closed off because I need to get some glass to cover this up so they stay in front of it. But let's see, I want them to be spawning and raid. Yeah, we're gonna put one. Oh, there. And there. There you. Alright, now. Random things. Block teleporter. This thing. Alright, let's see if I can do this. Might need to be standing up a little bit. Yes. Now this. This is the side that the thing is going to come out. So, whichever way you're looking, it's going to face the opposite way. I want it to come out right here. So I face that way and plop it down. I got to remember to bring down some glass with me. If I can get out of here. Alright, so that's one side. Let's get some of this glass while we're here. I don't want that glass, I want this glass. I'll submit. Now, on map, I marked out zombie spawner and skelly spawner. Alright, so we're gonna head on over to zombie spawner. And I'm pretty sure. Oh, really? Come on. Just about all my villagers are dead. This village was doomed the day I saw it and moved in. Poor guys, they never stood a chance. Now for the Velociraptor pen, I want this tall grass. I think it'd be perfect for them to be running around in. They're so freaking mean, vicious, and it'd be so Jurassic Park-like with the tall grass for them to run through. So how do these things work? Oh, dear God, I didn't. All right, let's go back. And set the target card. Target card is where you want your block to go. It's simply right clicking on the block teleporter that the item is coming from. So I want, or where the item is going to. I want the spawner to go into the hole, so I simply click, right click on it with the target card and it does the rest. Now on these block teleporters you can set a redstone signal. We're gonna do it on the other one. On this one it doesn't matter because I guess it just doesn't matter. I don't know. Alright, look at the target card, it just doesn't say a ship, right click, and now we look at it and it says, right here. That's where our block's gonna go. Alright, and we don't need that anymore. Well, we do, but not yet. Put the glass in. Yeah, we'll do that last. Let's have a little scare and see if we can give ourselves a heart attack with some zombies spawning in there. And I tried looking for a freaking tutorial on how these block teleporters work, but it wasn't really anything. I just played around with it in creative until I figured it out. It's not too hard. Figure out that you need the target card and which one do you click with it. And since when you right click it, it gives you the little icon showing you the target card. It's not that hard. There's a hole there. Jeez. Oh yeah, it's gonna be nighttime soon too. Oh, this is horrible. But yeah, those freaking... Oh, give me these flowers. Alright, so we wanted to face the opening to face that way, so we're gonna face the opposite way and place it down. You look at it and can't see anything. Anyways, you put your target card in there and you swap that and it's gone. Break it, get the target card back. And we need to run. Oh, there's the hole. You jumped it like a pro. Run, quick, hurry before we get swarmed. And these freaking things require ender pearls. That's why I got blown up by creepers. I was freaking hunting endermen. And wherever there's endermen, there apparently is like 50 creepers around too. I don't know why, but that's how it was. Why I freaking... Did I try flight? I did try flight. Oh well. I really don't need these farms anyways. But I did come to some realization about like recording everything. Where I'm at is not the easiest place to record. And I want to record everything. It's just so freaking hard to get the time just to record. It's freaking annoying. I hate it. So, yeah, I hear zombies. Yeah, I made it past the wall. Is that it? Come here, you. So, we gotta put this up. Alright. The great thing about these, you mess up, you just put it back. But we need you. Where are you? Oh crap, there were no. I put it right there, didn't I? Oh, where you come from there? Alright, grab a target card. Shift right click. Alright, we're gonna have to lock this off too. F7 says that. Ain't nothing gonna spawn up here. I don't see any spawn spots. At all. Where are they spawning? And then up here. There's that down there. Oh. Let's just push these back some more. I wonder if they... Let's see. I don't know if that'll affect the spawn or not. I really don't want to mess up the grinder. See, oh, look. It's killing them. And we got 400 mob essence in there right now. Awesome. Alright, let's go get that. Oh no. Look, we're running all the way back here to get freaking jump in bed real quick. I get distracted by a zombie. Oh, that's not safe. And neither is my house. Well, my almost gone. So. Between this episode and next episode, I'm gonna tear down this house. Let's get rid of those. Put down the footprint for this house. And I'm gonna make a copy of that room. On this side here, so I can get this, that, and the work table set up for dinosaur breeding. So I get working on that. Get out of here, you. Hate you guys so much. Yeah, get the dinosaur lab set up better. And after that, we're gonna get pretty heavy into Galacticraft, so we can get, well, yeah, we can get all the way up. We're gonna to get the rocket, get everything set up. Am I going the right way? Oh yeah, there it is. Yeah, get everything set up for. Get the rocket and everything set up. We're going to the moon. And then we're going to make a slight detour before we go there, though. I'm not sure if I'm going to do it on camera or not. It might be a surprise. I did it in creative, and it's funny. It's hilarious. I think that's what I'm going to do. I'll take a detour. I'll record it. And like jump back to and I'll record it beforehand, but you guys will see it after type thing, you know what I'm saying. If not, don't worry about it. I'm pretty sure I confused myself halfway through that. Anyway, let's grab this skelly spawner. Oh, why couldn't I find a. Where did, oh Jesus, way over there. Almost there. Let's go. Run. And there's a freaking giant wall in my way. Jesus, freaking giant wall. Why didn't you warn me? Alright, yes. Alright. Jelly spawner. We stand here. Throw the target card in there. And see it. Oh, there it goes. And we break in. Get our stuff back. Throw that nest egg. Throw that knapsack. Throw it in there. Ow. Then we run all the way back. Alright, now this is going to be a test episode. I'm going to see how this one goes and see if I like it or not. And either I'll stick to the trying to get the time to do the basically double episodes. I record like an hour and 20 minutes or so, and I just chop it right in half and call it two episodes. So that way you don't have to sit through the whole thing, but I don't know. It doesn't seem like good quality. Yeah. I don't know. There's not a whole bunch of you guys watching anyways, but I still want to do a good job. This is something I'm just trying out. So in here we should have a skelly spawner. And a zombie spawner. Now this is gonna give us the freaking essence to mob essence, jeez. To run the freaking auto spawner. And the honor spawner will be next episode. And it'll be something quick. All it is a little auto spawner from Mine Factory reloaded. And it's gonna spawn villagers, drop them right inside the smeltery, and turn them into netherworlds. And I'll show you that. And it's really easy. It'd be a quick thing, and then we'll go into Galacticraft. The moon. Wherever the moon, actually, the moon's like down there. Let's change. Here's zombies. I see skeletons flying. Yay. Why is it so... Oh, because there's light. Now, if I block this off... It's still because of those there. But they're spawning. And they die. And look at that. It's so easy. Up, put some covers on it and stuff like that. Make it look all nice. And you hear him dying, let's see. And they come up. Yep, you see? Stuff pops up there. And it gets sucked out. Throw that in there. Throw that in there. Alright, we got one torch over there. Throw that. Throw all that stuff in there. And whoa. Pop it up. So that's going to be it for this episode. And so next episode, we will... I'm going to repeat myself here. So that's it for now. But I'll, on this thing, this little farm, I don't know, I think I said it. The planter goes dead center. And it's 21 blocks by 21 blocks. So what you do is you center the harvester on one side halfway. So it's on the 11th block. There's 10 blocks that way, 10 blocks that way, and then this is dead center. And it will harvest every single thing that pops up. And the planter plants this whole area. It's a planter with a diamond upgrade does... a 21 by 21 square, and the harvester with the diamond upgrade does a 21 by 21 square in front of it. Planter centered, harvest is in front. That's why it's got the little teeth like the grinder. And just make sure you got the little sledge furnace to burn up that sledge. We're good to go. Look at 18 millibuckets. Alright, that's it for now. I'll see you guys next episode. Take care.